beautiful people. Today, we're going to tackle how to blur the background of a photo. The other term of this is bokeh. Bokeh is one of the most popular subjects in photography. The reason why it is so popular is because bokeh makes photographs visually appealing, forcing us to focus our attention on a particular area of the image. The word comes from Japanese language, which literally translates as blur. If you don't have a good camera and you want to put some bokeh effect to your photo, then Photoshop can help you to blur some part of the photo. This is an easy and fast tutorial. Hope you can follow it and learn something from it. Let's start. First, we have to open our photo in the Photoshop and duplicate the layer and rename the duplicate layer to foreground. Then, we have to select a subject that we are not going to blur later. There are lots of ways to select a subject, but we're going to use the Photoshop feature, which is the subject tool. To do this, click Select and click Subject. It will automatically select the subject. I want to blur the background that is far from the subject, so I will add this wood railings to the selection. To do this, I use the lasso selection tool. The next step is to put some gaps around the selection. To execute it, you have to click the Select menu and Modify and select Expand. Set to expand by 5 pixels or more. Now we have to remove the selected subject. To do so, click Edit and Content Aware Full. You can see on the preview panel that there are some shadows of the selected subject to the photo. Don't worry about it, because you are just after the edges, not the center, because that area is where the subject is located later. Don't forget to set the output to Duplicate Layer and click OK. Drag the foreground above the foreground copy. You can see the selection is still active. Create a layer mask on the foreground. Click the eye icon on the foreground copy and background to make it invisible. You can see the selected subject has some border around. To remove it, we have to go to Filter, then Other, and click Minimum. In this process, we have to set it to 6 pixels, 1 pixel more than the expand process we did a while ago. Set the preserve to roundness and click OK. Now, we have to hide the foreground layer by clicking the eye icon and unhide the foreground copy layer by clicking the eye icon again. The final step is to blur the background. To do so, go to Filter, click Blur Gallery, and click the Tool Shift. You can adjust the blur by sliding it to right to make it more blur or left to less blur. What I did here, I dragged the center to up in order to make all the background blur. Lastly, unhide the layers in order for you to see the result. You can see the background is blurry and the subject including the wood railings are not blurred. I did this to make it realistic, but still, it's up to you. I hope this tutorial is helpful to you, and please support our channel by subscribing to it. If you have some clarifications and subject you want me to tackle, please leave your comment below. Thank you! This last part of the video, I would like to dedicate to our dearest members who are supporting our channel through joining our membership perks. And I hope you will continue supporting us.